Church, it's time for our prayer scripture of the week. I hope that you're enjoying this. I hope that you're practicing this. We're practicing it in our home. It is something that I want to become a part of who I am each and every day, praying through his promises, praying his scripture out loud. His word never returns void. Anytime I say his word, it's going to come back to me. And so this is the power of saying his word, praying his word, reminding him of his promises out loud. Because what we put out there is always going to return to us a thousandfold, pressed down, shaken together, overflowing in the promises that he's given to us. I want you to go with me to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13. This is a short one, but it's an amazing set of scriptures, and it's one of many, many, many that speak to God's faithfulness. So 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13, I'm going to read from the ESV. Read from your own version, though. They're all basically going to get to the same point. Read something that speaks to you. I love the Message. I love ESV, but find one that really speaks to you and that you're comfortable with. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Screw that up a little bit. Let's try it again. For if we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. We are made in the image of God. We are made to reflect the very character of God, to live out the character of God. We represent him, every single one of us, not just those who serve him. Every one of us are made in the image of God. And the Bible is reminding us here in 2 Timothy that if we are faithless to him, if we are not representing who he is, if we are not good to him, if we are not serving him, if we are not loving him like he loves us, that he remains faithful to us because he cannot deny himself. When he looks at us, he sees himself and he's like, I can't deny myself. I have to bless them. I have to take care of them. I have to keep drawing for them. I will remain faithful. I will remain loyal. One of the things that speak to me is loyalty as a human. I am what people have called a loyal friend, and that's one of the greatest things that could ever be said about me. I want to be a loyal friend. I want to be faithful to people. And even though I'm human, that God is even more faithful than I am. He has not given up on you. In Jeremiah, he says, I am married to the backslider. That even if you run away from him, even if you don't know him, he said, I'm still married to you. I'm not giving up on this. I'm not giving up on you. I'm never going to stop reaching out for you. I'm never going to turn away from you. He is faithful. He is loyal. And he is a good, good God. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13. That is our prayer scripture of the week. This is an encouragement. This is a blessing that God is faithful. He will never turn away from us. He will never give up on us. He is married to me. He cannot deny himself because when he looks at me, he sees him. That is an amazing scripture that no matter what, he's going to constantly, he's never going to give up reaching for me. This doesn't mean I get to just do whatever I want, anywhere I want. It just means that he is never going to stop pursuing me. He's never going to stop loving me. He's never going to stop trying to get me to come back to him. And all of these other things that religion says, right? Rules and restrictions and all these things, those are natural responses whenever you are in relationship with him. Just like your relationships that you have with real people, with your mates, with your friends, you are naturally good to them. You naturally don't lie to them. You naturally don't abuse them. You naturally don't hurt them because you care about the relationship. The same thing is true for our Lord and Savior, that when we are in relationship with him, these are natural things that happen because we're in love with him. We want to please him, and he finds pleasure in blessing us. He's faithful even when we're faithless. I hope that's a blessing to you. Pray it out loud. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13. Until next time, we'll see you. God bless you.